What's up, guys? This is Brian Ralph, and today I'm bringing you something special, at least in my heart. The original Tony Hawk's Pro Skater HD. Obviously, the HD is newer. So here's the deal. In 2012, Activision Publishing Incorporated decided that they were going to basically... And this isn't a port, so normally what they'll do is they'll take the original game and port it and make it look a little bit better. This is actually, they took a lot of the original assets and ported them over and made them look better. But as far as like the maps, they were built from the ground up in Unreal Engine 3. So that's pretty cool. Now, this game doesn't look like a game from 2012. It looks like a game from like 2006, but that's fine because this is the original Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, which came out back in the 90s, and of course, like mid to late 90s, and of course looked like complete shit. This was my favorite game, and probably still is my favorite skating game, is what I meant to say, my favorite skating game of all time, even though there are better ones nowadays, obviously, but this one holds a lot of good memories for me, for sure. I was skating around the time when this came out. I was like 17, and I played this game for like 4 years. It was just great. All my friends were playing it. Everybody played it. Even after the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 came out, everybody was still going to this one. And it's awesome. So I'm not going to do like a review or anything because it's old. A lot of people know it already. I'm just going to take you through and play it a little bit. Do just a quick rundown of the HD version. And let you guys get a sneak peek at it. And that's pretty much it. So let's get started. Go with Rodney, and we'll start out with the warehouse. Wait, hold on. Okay. Now, unfortunately, I had to turn the sounds off for copyright reasons on YouTube, or not sounds, but the music. So there won't be any of the original soundtrack, which is all here, by the way, and it's like half of the game. It makes like half the game. Sadly, most of you will understand as to why I cannot add that. So this is the first level that everybody starts out on and learns the game on. Ouch. And yeah, it looks pretty good. I mean, it could look way better considering this was done in Unreal 3. It does not look like a game from 2012, but that's okay. Because if this was the original, it would look absolutely horrific. And it looks like 10,000 times better, so that's fine. I just wish they would have used the engine to its full potential, but, yeah, so we're just giving you a rundown. Boom. Oh, yeah. Ouch. But yeah, man, I mean, my friends played this all the freaking time. And there was good skating games before this came out. Like, the Thrasher skating games were really good. They were good, but they weren't... they didn't have the fluidity that this game does. It didn't feel nearly as fluid. And the graphics weren't as good, and the fluidity wasn't there, and it just felt like everything wasn't really connected that great. Like, the gameplay felt really clunky in the Thrasher series, and the physics were crap. It was a decent skating game, but of course, this blew it away. So when this came out, it was like, oh my god. You know, it was like night and day. It was like, wow. Okay, so this is the original first level that everybody learns on. So let's see. Go to the school, which is the second level that is unlocked. After you complete four of the missions on the first one under career, on the level we were just on, or the park or whatever you want to call it, then you get to go to the school, which is the next level you get to play on. Ah, how did I not make that? Like, shut up. Yeah, man, to this day, I still have to say this is my favorite skating game, just because this brought, like, this made a lot of the kids that were skaters back in the day, that some of them may be skaters as adults now, this made them skaters, you know? It made it, it brought it to the next level, to the next level of mainstream for a lot of kids, and this really introduced them to skating, and it's the reason why they skated, so that's really cool. To be able to say that, you know. While I just... Oh, what? I was trying to grind the top of it. I know you can if you do it just right, but it's a pain in the butt. Wow, that... Okay, that was lame. Alright, so this is the school level. I'm obviously not going to show off all the secret levels. This isn't like... This isn't a guide or a walkthrough or a full review of the game or anything. Just because, I mean, it's the original Tony Hawk. I mean, if you don't know about the game, it means you were probably way too young to know about it. And it's not anything, like, nowadays it's not anything special. It was back then. The HD version is pretty cool, though, because it brings it to the PC. And that's really cool. I was totally, I mean, $10 to just jam out on this. You know, as much as I want, it's totally worth it, man. Brings back so many memories. But like I said, I'm not going to show you everything or the secret areas or anything like that. This is just basically like a quick rundown of the HD version. So, do the hangar. The hangar wasn't really... The secret area in the hangar is really cool, but it wasn't really one of my favorite. I didn't really like the hangar. I still don't. It's just, it's small, aside from the secret area, and... Oh, yeah. Oops. Alright, so that's the hangar. I've never liked that level. It's not good in my opinion. And most people that I played with back in the day, like the kids, they didn't like it either. Alright, Mall, I have not been to this one yet since back in the day, so... Oh, I remember this. Yeah, you had to come up here and then hit that and then come down here and then hit this again. Oh, yeah, I remember this. Sort of. I mean, not, like, you know, but... This was a good level. I liked this level a lot. Or the map, or whatever you want to call it. Oh, that's right. You can jump through there. I forgot about that. God, it's so cool to see this, you know, and play this again. Especially on the PC. Like, how cool is that? And to see it in you know, a lot better graphics is so nice, too. Even though they're not anything special. Oh, yeah, I remember you could run all the way down here, and, like, I used to be awesome at this game, too, by the way, guys. You might not believe that, but I really was. I was a freaking pro at this game. I used to beat most of the teams that I played with. There were some that were better, but... I was probably like number 2 or 3. Oh, damn. Okay, so that's the mall. Venice Beach. This was one of my favorites, too. Oh, that's probably the fact that I've actually been here before. Never skated at Venice, but I have been here. Oh wow, I tried. Almost could have grinded that wire. Ooh, shit. Oh, crap. You guys hear weird noises in the background? Try to ignore that. I can't do anything about it. My neighbors are, like, they have one of those giant yellow cat bulldozers, like the 20-ton ones, and they're, like, tearing down trees and shit in the yard. I have no idea why or what they're planning on doing, but that's what they're doing, and it's making a lot of noise. So if you hear it, please bear with me. I can't do anything about it. Oh, crap. I didn't mean to do two kickflips. What the heck? And a lot, it's weird because on the Steam store, this game has mixed reviews. All the reviews are mixed, and it confuses me because I'm like, why? I've seen like one bug since I've been playing this for a couple hours. One bug. One glitch where I sunk into the ground, and I couldn't do much. And it glitched out. That was the only glitch I've seen. A lot of people complain about, like, just stupid crap. They're either, I don't know what they're complaining about, but it's just, I don't see anything wrong with it. I mean, it's perfectly playable. It looks fine. It looks a lot better than the original did. And, oh yeah, that was nice. See if I can. Oh yeah, nice. Yes, that's what I wanted. Yeah. Fuck yeah. Sand in your shoes. Nice. Yeah. Okay, I'll jump off. Nice, 191,000 on that. Hell yeah. Ooh. Okay, so that's Venice Beach. Downhill Jam. That's one of my favorites right here. Absolutely one of my favorites. Not good at it anymore, but boy, I used to be. I tell you guys, I used to be freaking awesome at this level, for sure. But back then I had to play it a million times to be really good at it, so, oh crap. What the heck? Really? You're gonna start me out there? Oh, I forgot about that. You could. Ooh, crap. Oh, come on. Come on. So, yeah. Oh, I could have spent a lot more time getting good at all these levels, like really, really good, like a couple of months, and then, like, posted this awesome video where I would have, like, you know, done awesome scores and tricks, but I don't want to play it that much. I just wanted to mess around with it a little bit, and I thought this would be a good game to make a video on. So don't expect, like, high-end scores or anything like that. I could do it if I wanted to, but I'm just trying to have fun. I'm not trying to, like, get into it bad like I did back in the day. Oh wow, really? I survived that? Really? Uh, Okay, so that's that. That's a good level, and then the warehouse. So we'll go to this, and yeah. This is just a basic skate park with a bunch of bowls, which is usually what I liked the best when I was skating. I like street skating a lot, but if I was going to go to a park, I like to go to parks like this, with just a bunch of big bowls all interconnected and stuff. It was the funnest to skate bowls. Like, if you had a big area like this with a bunch of bowls, it was just so much fun. Okay, that didn't work out too well. Ooh, crap. Let go of that a little too early. But yeah, if you guys are like me and you used to play this back in the day, definitely go check this out on Steam and give it a buy. I mean, it's totally, if you played this back in the day, it's totally worth it. If you haven't, and this was, you know, past your generation before you were born or whatever, or when you were a baby or something, then you probably wouldn't be interested in it. Even if you like skating games, you probably wouldn't. It'd probably be too old for you, but. Ooh, nice. I will say one thing about this game. The one thing I will say about it is it's held up really well. Whoa. It's held up really well. I mean, the mechanics are solid. It feels solid. It doesn't feel clunky. It doesn't feel slow. It doesn't feel clunky. It's very, very responsive. It's very smooth. It feels good when you do tricks. It feels good when you complete them. In the manner of which you do, like the way that you do tricks and stuff, feels normal. It feels good. It's held up really good. It's more than playable all these years later. And that's saying something for sure. That tells you how solid it was back in the day. If you can get on here and be just as satisfied with this as you can like a modern game, you know, as far as the controls and the way things feel. Of course, the physics are not very great, and you fuck up over stupid stuff sometimes. But that's to be expected with any older game, because, you know, physics back then always sucked. So. See if I can get a board slide. Board slide? Nope. Board slide? Nope. Well, I destroyed that speaker. Board slide? Nope. Oh, wow. Well, so that's Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, the original, very first one, but the HD version, of course. Anyway, this game holds a lot of nostalgia value for me, obviously. I love it, if you guys can't tell. It's pretty apparent. And there's lots of good reasons to love this game. So yeah, if you liked what you see, go give it, pick it up, $10, you can't really go wrong, give it a try and enjoy it, just have fun. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I just really wanted to share it with you guys, is all it really was about. It just means a lot to me and I wanted to share it. So thank you guys for watching, and as always, I'll catch you in the next one.